Membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, Wikipedia article audio. Membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, also known as mesangiocapillary glomerulonephritis, is a type of glomerulonephritis caused by deposits in the kidney glomerular mesangium and basement membrane thickening, activating complement and damaging the glomeruli. Pathology. Appearance. Type. Type I. Type 2. Type 3. MPGN accounts for approximately 4% of primary renal causes of nephrotic syndrome in children and 7% in adults. It should not be confused with membranous glomerulonephritis, a condition in which the basement membrane is thickened, but the mesangium is not. Membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis involves deposits at the intraglomerular mesangium. It is also the main hepatitis C-associated nephropathy. It also is related to a number of autoimmune diseases, prominently systemic lupus erythematosus. Also found with Sjögren syndrome, rheumatoid arthritis, inherited complement deficiencies, scleroderma, celiac disease. The histomorphologic differential diagnosis includes transplant glomerulopathy and thrombotic microangiopathies. The GBM is rebuilt on top of the deposits, causing a tram tracking appearance under the microscope. Mesangial cellularity is increased. There are three types of MPGN, but this classification is becoming obsolete as the causes of this pattern are becoming understood. Type I, the most common by far, is caused by immune complexes depositing in the kidney. It is characterized by subendothelial and mesangial immune deposits. It is believed to be associated with the classical complement pathway. The preferred name is dense deposit disease. Most cases of dense deposit disease do not show a membranoproliferative pattern. A 2012 review considers DDD to be in a continuum with C3 glomerulonephritis. One reason the use of type I to type 3 classification system is falling out of favor. Most cases are associated with the dysregulation of the alternative complement pathway. Spontaneous remissions of MPGN2 are rare. Approximately half of those affected with MPGN2 will progress to end-stage renal disease within 10 years. In many cases, people with MPGN2 can develop drusen, which is caused by same deposits within the Bruch's membrane beneath the retinal pigment epithelium layer of the eye. Over time, vision can deteriorate and subretinal neovascular membranes, macular detachment, and central serous retinopathy develop. Type 3 is very rare. It is characterized by a mixture of subepithelial deposits and the typical pathological findings of type I disease. A candidate gene has been identified on chromosome 1. Complement component 3 is seen under immunofluorescence.